Carla, part of the Wedding Women, and with us today we have Shannon, who is from Memories and Promises Photography.
Hi.
Hi, Shannon.
Thank you for having me here today. I don't have my duo partner, Sean, but we're a team, Sean and Shannon, of Memories and Promises Photography. Thank you for having me today.
You're welcome. I don't have my other half either. Andrea is coming, but she's a little late today. So we're going to get started. What can you tell me about photography?
Well, today I thought I could address something that's obviously very important, which is the consultation. So once you narrow down who you'd like to see and who you'd like to possibly hire for your wedding photography, it's very important that you have a consultation with that individual or that team. And whether it be by phone or Skype or in person, it's very important for them to take that time to meet them, and there are a number of reasons why that would be a step you would want to do.
So what would be some of the things you would be doing in a consultation?
So some of the things we'd be doing in a consultation, first, it's an opportunity for you as the bride and groom to get to know your photographer. And I don't think a lot of people realize how much time they spend with their photographer, but it's your entire wedding day. You are with your photographer. So I think one of the big things is, you know, do you like them? Would you be fine spending time with them? Are they a person or, you know, a team that you would, that would be like, yeah, I would have no problem hanging out with them that day because you're going to be hanging out with them that day. So that's huge as, you know, step one of just making sure that during the consultation that you have an easy flow and, you know, you don't need to be best friends, but have a nice connection with them so that you feel comfortable.
Very good. So are there, when someone hires a photographer, is there a list that you give the photographer, or does the photographer give you a list of the pictures that they would like to have taken?
That's a great question. So once you start doing your consultation, what we do at Memories and Promises Photography is that we go down and we first, you know, we discuss the attributes that come with a package for us, and we give a breakdown with those things. And then you should be discussing general timeline of, you know, how have you thought about how your day is going to flow. It's okay if you haven't, because quite a few, most of the time, we have a lot of brides and grooms who are, they have the date, they booked the venue, and now they're on photographer, so they haven't really thought about the process of the day yet.
Right. They're engaged, they have their dress, they're ready to get married. What else do you need? Right?
right. So, you know, you should be working with someone who understands the flow of the day and understands the concept of the wedding timeline and also a photography timeline, which are, you know, two different entities that need to be working together. So we work with, if you have a wedding planner, we work with the wedding planner to make sure that our timelines coincide correctly. And then, you know, adjust things here and there that need to be adjusted in order for everything to fit without anybody being stressed, because that's the biggest purpose of a timeline, is to make sure that, you know, everything is in that you want on your wedding day, but also that all of those things are met to your expectations while having a very nice, elegant flow of your day.
Right. I've noticed when I've been at weddings, I've been to a few.
For sure.
Just a few. But that after the ceremony, oftentimes there's a gap between the ceremony and when the reception starts because of the photography.
Right.
And that's obviously a very important time to have pictures taken.
Right.
What do you suggest they have their wedding guests doing during that time? Because you don't want to get shorted on if you miss those moments, they're gone.
Right. Well, it depends, because, you know, again, during the consultation, you have a discussion about having a first look. If you do have a first look, then we can get a lot of the family photography completed prior to the ceremony.
Oh, okay.
So that really is a big help. Also, after the ceremony, you do romantics if you haven't done a first look. So there's a lot of things to discuss, pros and cons of having a first look. The amount of time we have between the ceremony and the time that we start the reception. And most of the time, everyone's having a cocktail during cocktail hour is usually the case. So it also, what we do is we adhere to the plan that you are trying to achieve, because some people only have 45 minutes between the end of ceremony and their time. When we did a wedding at Disneyland, the ceremony was at a church, and then we did all of their family, and then we did all of the romantics, and then everybody met at Disneyland for the wedding, for the reception part of it. So we had like a 3-hour gap for everyone to be able to go and get lunch, get in, check into the hotel if they needed to, all of those things. Okay. So it really is important to discuss the timeline and how it's going to go, you know, according to what you would like and also what your photographer would suggest. And it's important that you have those discussions, because then when the day comes, especially if you have a wedding planner, everything just flows like butter, and you're happy and you're enjoying your day and you're not worried about a thing, and that's the whole purpose.
So do you teach them how to do some poses? Because you know there's that one pose you see all the time where she's like this, oh, and he's kind of bending over holding her like
that.
So
like that. The dip?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. I'm like, how do you do that? I'd be on the floor.
Well, one thing we would highly recommend that we recommend with any of our couples is that we have an engagement session. We have an engagement session as a complimentary feature in all of our packages, because that gives you an opportunity not only to spend some time in front of the camera, spend some time with us, and also for you to feel comfortable in learning different poses and things. And, you know, even we've had a lot of grooms that are nervous about that portion of it. And by the time they're done, they're like, I was really worried and this was easy. So okay. I don't know if that is the case with every photographer, but this is one of the main reasons why we give a complimentary engagement session, is so that they have that opportunity to feel comfortable in front of the camera and in front of us and being united together and not worried about how is my posing, but having more of a fluid day when you're enjoying your day.
Okay. Is there a favorite place that people like to take pictures? I see a lot in the fields, on the road. You know those pictures like on the road, on the railroad tracks,
which is illegal, but
okay.
But we do have some special locations depending on where we shoot, that have railroad tracks that are no longer in use.
So
we will not be giving those special locations away on camera or YouTube.
You have to go to them.
That's
first.
Right. Uh-huh. So we have that. You know, everybody is different, and so some are, I really want green, or I really want a country ranch feel, or I want beach. So we discuss with them. We share an entire portfolio of things that we've done in the past and give them ideas and suggestions, and then we go from there. So we shoot everywhere. We've shot all over California. So sky's the limit when it comes to that. And it just depends on really what they're looking for.
And I have to say, we've seen them work and we've seen their work. They're phenomenal. Very professional. Lots of fun.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're great.
That.
You're great.
Thank you.
These are good people.
Thank you. It's we put a lot of time and energy into the process. Because the main thing is we want you to have an amazing day. And so we're not going to show up on your wedding day and be like, okay, what's the plan? Well, it's already way planned.
And let's face it, in the end, those photographs are one of the few things you get to take with you.
Right.
Right?
Right.
As great as the day is, and it should be made important and special, but when it's all over, there's very little that comes home with you.
Right.
The dress comes home with you. Don't forget the dress.
Yes. I still have mine.
Right? My mom's is here in the store. It's 69 years old now.
Oh.
That's what you take home with you, really.
Right. And then that's part of the consultation, is asking questions like, you know, what comes in my package? And, you know, do you include digital images? Do you include prints? Do you include albums? Things of that sort. In our particular package, we also include special edits and okay. that are part of the package. So it all just depends on what your photographer is providing for you. So you should be asking all of those questions to make sure that you're getting the things that you want achieved. And then also another big thing is making sure that you may have the most amazing photographer, well known throughout the land, but do you actually enjoy their style? The style of the way that they shoot.
That's a huge.
Yes.
You can see that in different wedding pictures.
Right.
The photographers definitely have a style unique to each one of them.
Right. Right. And it's important that, you know, what are you gravitating towards? When you go on social media, when you go on Instagram, when you're flipping through, when you're on Pinterest, what are you pinning? What are your colors look like? What does your style look like? Are you more photojournalism, which means capturing the moment without direct eye contact with the lens? Do you like traditional, where you do like things posed and set up directly? Do you like a combination of both? Those are things that you can discuss with your photographer, and just make sure that you have the style that you're looking for. Even if their work is amazing, that may not be what you're looking for. As far as the style for your own wedding. Well, so that's something that you need to think about.
That makes sense. And we get girls coming in all the time where they Pinterest different dresses, and they come in, they're like, I want this. And when we start trying it on, it's a whole different world.
Right.
And so until you really get in there and know what you want, meet the photographer, it's a completely different feeling.
And you can also, with us, you can also just purchase an engagement shoot yourself, where there's no commitment to anything, and you can actually just experience having an engagement shoot with us. And then that way you can see, like, you know, I don't think I'm not bragging, it's just every time that we've done that, that's been a definite booking, because they really get the experience and they're like, yes, this is what we want to do. But if you are kind of like, you know, I like this style of photographer, I enjoy them, and I think I do want to do an engagement shoot before making a commitment, that's always something that you can ask in the consultation without
That's
having to
idea.
Worry.
Yeah.
Right. And get that experience so that you can see what you'll be receiving on your wedding day. So
right. Because there's nothing worse than realizing it wasn't what you really wanted. The wedding's over and you're done.
Right. So that's the consultation is a very important opportunity for you to get to know them, for them to get to know you, to make sure that you have the right style. Start discussing things that you know you want to include. We always have couples that want to include certain things on their wedding day, and some are regular, normal things, and some of them are like unique and different that you want to make sure and have those on your day. And they have to be included in the schedule to make sure that that's not missed. And that's important.
Oh,
otherwise,
right.
The day goes so fast that it could be skipped over, not intentionally.
Right, right.
So, and probably the last thing would be the post-wedding. Okay, so we've done the wedding. The wedding's been shot. And then having that discussion of, okay, what is your time for delivery? What is your process for delivery?
Okay.
And for example, us ourselves, we do an initial light edit, and you have your own online gallery in which you view your images, and you pick what are your favorite, and then we do a second edit on those final.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So that,
very nice. So you have more of a hands-on to what you get to pick that you're going to have in your package, right, as far as the individual photographs.
Right. And sometimes you don't realize that an image will adhere to a very beautiful black and white or something until you see them. So you can make those requests at that time that I would also like to have this image in a black and white or this, okay, you know, sepia or,
right,
something of that sort, right, if that's something that you choose as well.
Great.
Yeah.
Okay. I am so glad to have you here.
Oh, thank you for inviting me.
Isn't she wonderful? We love her.
Thank you.
So, you have a website?
We do. It's mnpphotos.com.
Okay.
And it stands for Memories and Promises Photography, but you know, online you've got to shorten things,
yes,
up.
Yes.
And all of our handles are the same, mnpphotos. So, our, okay, Instagram is the same, mnpphotos, okay, Pinterest. So you can find us there, and stay tuned because we're also about to add video to our packages.
Oh, great.
Yes. So
great.
We, okay, might have to bring in our video team and do another one.
Well, let's do that. Okay.
Okay,
all right.
Great.
Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
It's been lovely to be with you today. I hope you've enjoyed it and learned something. For now, have a great day.
Bye.